much. All right. I had so much to say that I wrote it down in a script tonight. I'm going old school. I'll tell you what, that last song, and happy Father's Day. Hey, my son just called me and he said, happy Father's Day, and I gotta go on stage. He says, oh, okay, all right, that's where you're gonna be. Originally I wanted to call the show A Big Steaming Pile of Greg, but cooler heads prevailed. Anyway, the reason we played that song first was because my dad saw me becoming a nerd. I would stay in my room and draw and look at comic books. Finally, he said, you have to have a hobby. I'll buy you a musical instrument and you learn how to play it. Well, the first thing I thought of was the guy playing timpani, walking up and down the football field, you know, looking like you just wanted to beat him up so bad. And then the fat guy with the tuba. And then I heard Dick Dale doing Miserloo. And I said, damn! That sounds like a guy running across the goal line, making a touchdown. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the reason that I am here tonight at the Belly Up. Thank you, Dick Dale. And thank you all for coming out tonight. I was in a few psychedelic bands over the years, but I was asked to join a band called Hot Tuna. And I got a call. I remember my father-in-law wrote down the name. He said, Jockey Kicky Poo called. I said, who's that? He said he was from a band that was some kind of hot fish. I said, well, okay, that must have been Jockey Kicky Poo. I figured out must have been Jorma Kalkinen. So we're going to do a couple of Hot Tuna tunes right now. Thank you. embryonic journey. Now, ladies and gentlemen, my partner in crime, Wild Rose.
Are you ready for some blues?
Yeah.
All right, me too.
All right, the first version I heard of this was Jorma, or as he's known on the East Coast, Jorma. And Janis Joplin singing, and Jorma's wife, Margareta, who was the strongest, meanest woman I ever met in my life. She kicked a soccer ball at a door in a studio and left a hole in the studio door. You did not mess with this woman. She was playing typewriter on this as percussion, and it was pretty bitchin'. We don't have a typewriter because they don't exist, but we're gonna do this anyway.
See that dollar first, whoa, how long do I have to wait? Can I get you now, baby, must I hesitate? Swim to the bottom and I'd never come up. Oh, how long, dear, must I have to wait? Can I get you now, baby, must I hesitate? Well, the rocks in the ocean, fish in the sea, Lord knows you mean the world to me. Oh, how long, Lord, must I have to wait? Can I get you now? Ooh, must I hesitate? Got those hesitation shoes. Oh Lord, I got the hesitation blues. How long, dear, must I have to wait? Can I get you now? Ooh, must I hesitate? Can I get you now? Baby, must I hesitate? baby.
Thank you.
Yes. Well, so much for that part of my life. I developed a strong friendship. Does anybody remember the Quicksilver Messenger Service? I saw them and I said, that is the weirdest guitar player I've ever seen in my life. And he turned out to be an equally strange guy. And of course, we immediately became great friends because we had this odd sense of humor, which those of you who know me are familiar with. I heard somebody say, oh, yeah, yeah. John Cipollina was recognized by the Rolling Stone magazine as one of the 100 top guitarists in rock and roll. And it was not for his chops. It was not for his Eddie Van Halen blazing, you know, whatever. It was the fact that he was different. And this is an example of his playing, song called Pride of Man. Trying to make it just out of tune enough to be really San Francisco.
That is.
Turn around, go back down, back the way you came. Can't you see that flash of fire? 10 times brighter than the day. And behold, a mighty city broken in the dust again. Oh God, pride of man broken in the dust again. Turn around, go back down, back the way you came. Babylon is buried in her shame. Their mighty men are all beaten down. Their kings are falling in their ways. Oh God, pride of man broken in the dust again. Turn around, go back down, back the way you came. Sword of God is raised. Yes, Babylon, backed by its city, rich in treasure, wide in fame. Oh God, pride of man broken in the dust again. Tower to fall, make of you a pyre of flame. Oh, you who dwell on many waters, rich in treasure, wide in fame, you bow unto your God of gold. Your pride of might shall be ashamed, for only God can lead his people back unto the earth again.
In San Francisco, right at ground zero, man. It was such a great time to learn about music. I just threw the script away. And another group that I was privileged to tour with for several months was called Big Brother and the Holding Company. This was post-Janet. Unfortunately, but there were a whole series of wonderfully talented vocalists who did Janet and did it wonderfully. And I have one of them here tonight. Caroline Martin. This woman kills Janet. No, that sounded wrong. This woman does a great job of Janet. I'm going to shut up and let her sing.
I'm ready. You feel good.
Caroline Martin. My God.
Thank you so much, everybody. What a crowd.
Also, while I wasn't looking, another old friend snuck up here. Mr. Joe Hastings on bass. I've known Joe for 20 years, and he is—he does it all, man. If your computer breaks, he'll take a piece of gum and a paperclip, and he'll fix it. How about another Janis tune?
Happy Father's Day, by the way. This one goes out to my daddy. Busted flat in Baton Rouge, waiting for a train. Feeling it faded as my jeans. Bobby thumbed the diesel down just before rain. Took us all the way down to New Orleans. Well, I pulled my poon out of my dirty red bandana. Played a song while Bobby sang blues. Windshield wipers slapping Thomas, holding Bobby's hand in mine. Played every song that Javi knew. Freedom just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing, it ain't nothing, hun, if it ain't free. Feeling good was easy, love, when Bobby sang the blues. Ah, feeling good was good enough for me. Ooh-hoo. Good enough for me. Of my soul in all kinds of weather and everything he done. You know, Bobby, baby, kept me from the cold. Now one day down in Salinas, I heard he slipped away. Well, he's searching for that home, and I hope he finds one. Well, I trade on my tomorrows for one. To mine. Freedom just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing. And that's all that Bobby left me. Yeah. Feeling good was easy, Lord, when Bobby sang the blues. Ah, feeling good was good enough for me. Ooh-hoo. Good enough for me and my Bobby. Sing it with me, everybody. Na na na, na na na, na 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 na, na 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 na, Bobby McGee. Let me hear you. Na 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 na, Bobby McGee. Na na na, na 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 na. Best I can, I said, hey, hey, Thank you so much, everybody. Hi, Mom.
Great.
Dad.
Joe Hastings.
Well, let's see here. You know what? Yeah, that's a good question. After I wrote Jungle Love, which will be coming later in the show, the co-writer and I, Lonnie Turner, got together and said, well, I guess we're hot songwriters now, so Eddie Money approached us for a tune. And we co-wrote a song for him for an album that was called Playing for Keeps. And they released the wrong single off the album. If our song had been the first single, instead of driving my little red Prius out back,
it is red.
There would be a bright red Porsche with the license plate Bad MF. But no, they had to put out the reggae single. But you get to hear the song tonight as it was originally intended. And this is going to be sung by our new secret weapon, Mr. Mark Knoll.
Thank you.
No pressure.
Trinidad, Trinidad, Trinidad.
Father's Day to me.
Yes.
Thank you. And Mark Knoll.
Thank you.
I mean, we were sitting around in rehearsal. I said, well, who's going to sing this song? He comes in and starts singing
Eddie
like
Money.
That. I said, oh, my God.
Yeah, Mark.
Thank you, brother.
Little Eddie Money talk?
Yeah. You know what? You can't, it's like potato chips. You can't just have one Eddie Money tune, right? I had nothing to do with writing this, but this is such an Eddie Money earworm that it will stick with you for the rest of the week. So we're having Tyler come up to sing this one.
Correct, Tyler.
Tyler Buckley doing two Tickets to Paradise.
Disappear. We waited so long. Waited so long. We waited so long. Waited so long.
You know it, come on.
I've got two tickets to paradise. Won't you pack your bags and leave tonight? I've got two tickets to paradise. Won't you pack your bags? Disappear. You know why? Waited so long. We waited so long. Waited so long. Waited so long. I've got two tickets to paradise. Won't you pack your bags and leave tonight? I've got two tickets to paradise. Won't you pack your bags and leave tonight? I've got two tickets to paradise. Won't you pack your bags and leave tonight? I've got two tickets to paradise. I've got two tickets to paradise.
Yeah, thank you, everybody.
Tyler Buckley.
Well, well.
Back to the history lesson. Steve Miller quit working around 1982, and I said, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? What am I going to do? And that's exactly what came to me. I said, I have to rock and roll because I can't do anything else. And I got a call from a Polish fellow named Greg Kihn. And the first song that we went in the studio and cut together was called Our Love's in Jeopardy, which turned out to be a great good luck charm for us. But before we do that, we're going to do his first hit, which is called the breakup song. Now, you remember, that's the song that goes, right? Do you know the reason that's in there is because he couldn't think of anything else to sing. And they said, where's the rest of the word? And the producer said, no more words. It's easy to remember, as you're about to find out. And Hector Toro comes forward again. The multi-talented Tyler Buckley is back on the drums.
Just an hour before, and now I'm staring at the bodies as they're dancing across the floor, and then the band slowed the tempo and the music took me down, it was the same old song with a melancholy sound, strange out in the atmospheres, and then the band played the tempo that I used to know, and now I'm staring at the bodies as they're dancing so slow, I
so easy to say that you'll forget your past. They don't ride them like that anymore. 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 They don't. No, they don't. No, no. They don't ride them like that anymore.
Thank you so much. Now, picture this. I've just joined the Greg Kihn Band, and the great part is they fired their other guitar player because he was doing too many drugs.
Oh, my goodness.
And they hired me.
And they hired Greg. Oh,
oops.
No.
Oops. However, the first song I touched in that band, the first song I recorded, went to number one. It made Greg and his co-writer filthy, nasty, rich, so they kept me around. You know, kind of like a stray dog that poops gold, you know? And this became number one, not just on the pop charts, but on the rhythm and blues charts. And the one time my dad said, attaboy, we were watching the Friday Night Frights together, and they played my guitar solo over one of the beatings. You know, he saw blood flying everywhere. My guitar solo came on, and I told my dad, I said, Dad, that's me. And he looks at me, he says, good job, son. It fits the moment perfectly.
Happy Father's Day indeed.
Happy Father's Day.
All right, Mark. Thank you.
Rose.
Nice job, Rose. Nice job.
Oh, my Lord.
You guys rock. Thank you for coming out. Yeah.
Thank you, San Diego.
All right,
we're good.
I'm all over the map historically. Before there was Hot Tuna, before there was Greg Kihn, before there was Steve Miller, there was a little tiny short orange-haired Irishman named Van Morrison. I got a call from his road manager one day. He said, "Greg, Van's band is working out great." They later on, his band became known as Huey Lewis in the News. But the guitar player apparently was having some trouble with some of the subtleties in Van's music. So they said, "Would you like to come in for an audition?" And of course, I started things off right by showing up an hour late. But Van and I got along very, very well. We became really good friends, which made me question my mental stability. But he was charming with me, man. He was a funny guy. He just got tired of people kissing his ass, and I was, you know, I didn't do it, so.
Oh, yeah.
Eventually, I mean, the road manager called me and said, "I know you and Van are chummy now, but, you know, eventually he's going to fire you because that's what he does." So, you know, the axe fell. So I joined up with Hot Tuna, and I'm packing to go to New York, and I get a phone call from Belgium. And forgive my terrible North Ireland Irish accent, but he says, "Hey, Greg, this is Van." I said, "Van, where are you calling from, man? Your connection sounds horrible." He says, "I'm calling from Belgium, and I missed the sound of your guitar." I said, "Well, okay. So, well, thank you. That's very nice. He says, "If I send you a ticket, will you come over? We can hang and we can play some music." And I said, "Well, okay. There's one little problem, Van. You fired me. And Hot Tuna hired me, and we're leaving for New York tomorrow, so I really can't come to Belgium." And there's this long silence, and Van says, "Well, what kind of fucking loyalty is that?" Fast forward 30 years, I worked with his daughter on a CD. He was putting together a band. I said, "Would you tell Van that I'm available?" He said, I brought up your name immediately. And I said, "What did he say?" He said, "Greg Douglas doesn't want to play with me." It's a true story. I know, I'm a dick, you know. Here's a very, very early Van Morrison song from them. The ugliest band to ever come out of Ireland.
That's cool.
Thank you.
don't go. Babe, please don't go down to New Orleans. You know I love you so. Babe, please don't go. Bobby, our doll. Bobby, our doll. Bobby, our doll. Get your way down here, let you walk alone. Babe, please don't go.
Early Van to late Van. This is, I gotta grab my other guitar. Hang on.
Again, happy Father's Day. Thank you all for coming out. Gotta dedicate this before Greg speaks about a little bit to my wife, Carrie, a good friend, Courtney, and last but not least, Michelle.
Courtney Havigan.
This is,
No.
That was a tune by Jimi Hendrix that was not released on one of his earlier albums. This is a song that has the line in it, I want to rock your gypsy soul. And Hector and I are going to bring it way, way down so you can really hear the words.
The sun, where the bunny boat was won, we sailed into the mist. Hark now, hear the sailors cry, smell the sea and feel the sky. Let your soul and spirit fly as we sail into the mist. And when that foghorn blows, I'll be coming home. Yeah, when that foghorn blows, gotta hear it. Don't have to fear it. I wanna rock your gypsy soul, just like in the days of old. Together we will flow into the mystic. Thank you.
foghorn blow, you know I'll be coming home. Yeah, when that foghorn blow, gotta hear it. Don't have to fear it. I wanna rock your gypsy soul, like in the days of old. Magnificently we will flow into the mystic.
Somewhere, all right, one more. This is going to be a stumper. Does anyone remember, first of all, Mike Bloomfield? Do you remember when the top three guitar players used to be Jimi Hendrix, Eric Clapton, and Mike Bloomfield? Mike started a band called The Electric Flag. They had their debut at the Monterey Pop Festival. Unfortunately, the pressures of keeping the band together made Mike kind of go off the deep end. But they came out with one great album, and this is a song from that. And I was asked to join the band after Mike died, and I joined them for several tours, and talk about an honor, you know. Big shoes to fill. But this is a song called Texas. We sung once again by the lovely Carolina Martin.
Get it, Carolina. That's it.
I've just got in from Texas, baby. You didn't even know I was around. I just got in from Texas, babe. You didn't even know I was around. I saw you on the streets, baby. You looked at me like I was a Ringling Brothers clown. Yes, you did. Don't know why I come back, baby. Just to be in your I have to lose my pride. And you know I did. Come on, Bowie. Say hello to Mark one more time. so long.
Hey, hey. A woman don't understand, baby. When a woman has been gone so long.
Yes.
No, no. She won't say what's the matter, baby. But you know, there's something wrong. Yeah. I just got in from Texas, baby. My life just won't be the same.
Caroline whispers in my ear, that was fun.
That was fun.
We have a very, very, very special guest coming up. I recently did a CD that I consider to be the best piece of music that I've ever done. It's called The Flight of the Golden Dragon. It's on sale back at the merch table. And I co-wrote it with a gentleman named Michael Muldoon. Michael? Michael.
Hey, Michael.
Michael Muldoon. Just Michael, say hello to the folks while I switch guitars.
Hi. How you doing? Oh, great. Good to see you guys. I have to say, it's a great pleasure to be here. I'm really grateful for Greg for putting this show together. Recognizing 50 years in music is quite substantial, don't you think? Mr. Substantial. That's my new name for him. So we're gonna do 3 songs off the album, right? Yeah.
Where? 50 years of anything. I should get 50 years in the music business. I should get a standing ovation for being able to stand up.
Mexico, eh? Go England tomorrow.
Yeah, mate.
He's speaking English right now.
Anyway, for our second song. You walk into my life,
unchain my heart, just to tear it apart. Oh, there was a time when I could not see. I was played like a fool. It was a sin to be me. And all of my dreams, they turned into fears. I started to scream, oh, making me scream. Those long dark days, oh, turned into years. They were making me scream, oh, making me scream. Walking slowly in time, always looking from behind. Blind. I feel it's my time to shine. So take away the restraint. Oh, let the beast be free. Cause I found love at last. Now it's time to be me. And all of my dreams, I no longer feel. My dreams could come true. If I could set them free, there'll be no reason for me. I won't have to scream. I'll no longer scream. If I'm set free, there's no reason for me.
Greg Douglas and these fantastic band behind us. So this is the first song that we ever wrote together. Is this one? Yeah. Let's call the fine line. nights, even shorter days. Fame became so famous, started out that way. The planning and deceiving, it happened every day. Silk stockings, creamy velvet skins, so many invitations, urging you to sin. Won't play in the field, it seemed the only way. There's a fine line between the vice that you choose, choices you make, there's a chance that you lose. No time for thinking, no tears of regret. You did what you wanted, it's a time to forget. It's a fine line between the best that we choose. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. Labeled as a sinner, the one without a friend, like some beginner, blindsided in the end. Now it's come full circle, where it all began. Friends we started out with, they've all been and gone. You left to find the meaning under a lifetime of remorse. It's a fine line between the past that you choose, choices you make, there's a chance that you lose. No time for thinking, no tears of regret. You did what you wanted, it's a time to forget. It's a fine line between the best that you choose. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. Labeled as a sinner, the one without a friend, like some beginner, blindsided in the end. It's a fine line, being the best that you choose. Choices you make, there's a chance that you lose. No time for thinking, no tears of regret. You did what you wanted, it's a time to forget. It's a fine line between the best that we choose. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. You're labeled as a sinner, the one without a friend. Like some beginner, you're blindsided in the end. Guitar.
Yeah.
Yeah, baby.
Shut her down.
This is the most positive song I've ever heard in my life. This is from the pen of Michael Muldoon. Again, all this wonderfulness is available back at the merch stand, so that's the last shameless promotion I'll be doing.
Flows as the west wind blows, brings a breeze across my face. The rise and fall that brings some peace to those who venture and fall from grace. The ones who stray from place to place and never settle down. Awake desires and feelings of hope disappear without a trace. They bring me hope, oh, bring me hope. Oh, this feeling gives me hope. It gives me hope. It gives me hope. These feelings and stories give me hope. The innocence of children playing with their friends. Those days we thought they'd never end. Couple walking down the street, holding hands for everyone to see. The legacy they'd leave, even skeptics would believe. Something could last over half a century. It gives me hope. It gives me hope. Oh, these feelings give me hope. They give me hope. Oh, give me hope. These feelings and stories give me hope. These are the stories, they shape our lives. They give a meaning, open up our eyes. To come full circle where it all began. Is it real to be the only one who knows the truth? Which road to take, keep in the faith. Oh, and save us from our fate. These are the stories, they shape our lives. These are the stories, oh, they help us to survive. They give me hope, oh, give me hope. Oh, these stories give me hope. They give me hope, oh, give me hope. These feelings and stories give me hope. They give me hope. Oh, give me hope. These feelings and stories give me hope. They give me hope. Oh, give me hope. These feelings and stories give me hope.
Thank you very much. Bless you. Big hand for the band. Please, give the guys a big hand.
Michael Muldoon. I... Thank you. Michael. Oh, God. Thank you so much. Michael. All right, I'm gonna do a song for my wife.
Where's Jerry?
She deserves it, man. She's, 50 years in the music business. She suffered through 23 years of me. So, this is a song. There we go.
Jerry, put your hands up so everybody knows who you are. There she is, right there. There she is.
She's an angel. a saint.
Yeah, this is a song that... that was actually on three Steve Miller albums. And Steve loved it. We actually did this live with the whole laser show and kettle drums and dancing girls. No, there were no dancing girls. Pardon me, this is kind of an esoteric tuning here. Please suffer through it for one more moment. Before we go on, I want to say, I was so worried all week. I said, are people going to show up? Is anybody going to be here? And look at you. I am gonna sleep like a baby tonight. This is called Maelstrom. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Man, I was sweating on that one.
Yep. As long as we're in tune, we're good.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think now it's time to present a mystery. You've been wondering for years what this means. What is the pumpitus of love? We have a Steve Miller tribute band that's called the Pompetus of Love. So now when somebody says, well, what does Pompetus of Love mean? Oh, it's this bitchin' band from San Diego, man. They'll be so disappointed. But here it comes, man, the Steve Miller stuff.
Tyler!
You guys having a good time? Yeah, that was easy.
Oh,
come on and dance, come on and dance. We may not get another chance. You know the night is falling and the music's calling. We've got to get down, swing down. Yeah. We've been working so hard.
Sound great, everybody.
Keep on rocking me, baby. here's another sing-along for you.
All right, quick. Because I've been around for 50 years, I have all the stories. Steve Miller had been on Capitol Records for 10 years. He'd never had a hit. He put out all these great albums and all this dope, smoking, heavy. Oh, God, he's great. But Capitol Records was a bunch of suits. They said, Steve, if you don't have a hit single on your next album, you're out of here. So Steve put on his bulldog face, his jaw strutted out. He said, I'm going to go home and write the worst piece of crap that will appeal to every teenage moron in the United States of America. I was one of those teenage morons, and I loved it.
That's right.
Yeah.
Some people never grow up.
Thank you.
I really love your peaches, wanna shake your tree. You gotta sing it. Picker. Sound terrific. I can't believe you heard that song before.
Let's hear it for the audience.
Yeah. What's the next? I don't know.
Well, here's a song that we call around my house the mortgage payer.
I hate to ruin our sound now. Tune it up anyway. What the hell? Well, I was in a band in eighth grade in junior high. We couldn't pull this one off, but we did another one off the record. But this one was on it, and we loved it, and I still do, man. It goes something like this.
That's right. Here we go. Do you have that funny sound yet, Mark, on this?
Which one?
He doesn't have the funny sound, but somebody whistle at the end of this, okay?
Oh, that sound!
Jungle love, it's driving me mad, it's making me crazy. Roberts, everybody. That's a nice tune, man.
Time for a couple more here.
Thank you. That's a true
Thank
story.
You. Get quiet on me, will you? We got one more, and then we don't want to go, but we got to go. So, wow, I haven't heard that since the 60s. All right, here we go.
Thank you.
that's Greg. He puts a psycho in psychodelia. You know what I'm saying? I'm peaking, man. The time keeps on slipping, slipping, slipping into the future. Time keeps on slipping, slipping, slipping into the future. Let's take it to the chorus, what the hell? I want to fly like an eagle to the sea. Fly like an eagle, let my spirit carry me. I want to fly like an eagle till I'm free. Fly into the revolution. Much, everybody. Greg Douglas.
Thank you. Tyler Buckley.
Thank you much.
Caroline Martin-Garrett. Wild Rose. Mark Knoll, the incredible Mark Knoll. Oh, James East. And of course, Hector Toro. Thank you.